what kind of students will get to go through into the graduation, whether they are eligible, whether they are not eligible. Of course, everybody is eligible, but then, you know, it always depends on मैंने कितना मेहनत किया है, आपने कितना मेहनत किया है वगैरह वगैरह. So there is a definite, you know, demarcation on those who worked hard throughout their 2 years, 11th and 12th, and what were their aspirations, and therefore they were, I'm sure they were prepared for something great, you know, whether it's engineering or medicine or whatever it is. And naturally, subsequent downstream activities like CET, entrance exams, and so on and so forth. So naturally, those things are the major impact. So non-eligible as well as eligible students, those who did not work hard versus those who worked hard, it should not get in, get, it shouldn't get averaged out. Naturally, the first solution is career guidance, that irrespective of what you have scored, you know, marks, whatever, whether you've scored high marks or no marks or low marks, does not really matter, I think, because today it's a question of skill, less knowledge, more skill. I'm not saying knowledge is not required, certificate is required, but I think first one needs to definitely get a handle on where is one going, what is the direction, where are you going to see yourself 50 years after you graduate, because you'll be working for the next 40 to 50 years in a world of work. So that's the first solution, get yourself career guidance done. And number two is, while you are waiting for the results, I think get your career guidance done and look for acquiring certificates which should not stop you from doing what you need to do or getting where you need to get.